D.D. Shannon, hitbound on KDWB. Jackie, of course, toured with the Beatles the last time they were in the KDWB country. Great sound. It's what the world needs now is love.
Hundreds of people are saving hundreds of dollars on new 65s this week during the Hopkins Car Dealers annual open air sale. 1,000 new 65s on sale on the parking lot, Hopkins High School, Highway 7.
KDWB Sports Scoreboard.
What may be the most important game of the Minnesota Twins to date is scheduled for this afternoon at Comiskey Park in Chicago. The Twins will either be a game and a half in front of the pressing Chicago White Sox, or they'll be a half game out after this afternoon's game. The Sox closed to a half game margin last night by upsetting the Twins 3-1. Deciding the fate of the two teams in today's game will be Jim Cott with a 5-7 record for the season, facing Chicago's Joe Horland, who boasts a 6-4 record. The game is the rubber game of a three-game series. 8 games are on the Major League Baseball schedule, including 2 afternoon contests, one of which the Minnesota Twins-Chicago White Sox game. The other day game, Boston is at Detroit. At night in the American League, Washington is at Cleveland and Baltimore at New York. After dark in the National League, San Francisco visits Los Angeles, Chicago is at Houston, Pittsburgh plays at St. Louis, and Philadelphia is at Milwaukee. Richfield, St. James, Virginia, and St. Paul Humboldt emerged as victors in the opening round of the 19th Annual State High School Baseball Tournament at St. Paul's Midway Stadium yesterday. The losers in yesterday's rounds meet today in the consolation rounds. Brainerd is slated to play Norwood Young America at 1 p.m., and Bemidji plays Northfield at 2:30. Manager Al Lopez of the Chicago White Sox will pilot the American League team in this year's Major League All-Star game to be played at Met Stadium July 13th. The National League All-Star manager is Gene Mark.
Mark Schilling, if you get past the harem guards, how will you know which wife does the cooking?
Simple, Rosemary. I'll try a little pinch here, a little pinch there.
Mark, stop that.
Do you think of gravy as a gamble? Well, you can relax in pleasant confidence when you use Schilling gravy mixes. There are 5 rich Schilling gravies: mushroom, chicken, and savory herb gravy mix. Each one is blended to perfection, is prepared in just minutes, and flavor is always exactly right. Naturally, if you want to add a seasoning touch of your own, Schilling gravy mixes are very flexible. Try all 5.
It's no secret, Schilling flavor makes all the difference in the world.
Look for the tantalizing pan-roasted Schilling gravy mixes at Erickson supermarkets in Hudson, New Richmond, and River Falls. On KDWB, the score comes sooner.
KDWB.
One of the top banana hit sounds on KDWB. That's Mrs. Brown. You have a lovely daughter, Herman's Hermits. Silhouettes by Herman's Hermits coming up here on the flip side of Twin City News this hour. The morning report, Thursday, June 17th, 68. Current degrees, 75 for an afternoon high.
This week's TV Times offers thumbnail sketches on the 27 leading characters who reside in Peyton Place. Discover why Beatle John Lennon fears growing old. Take a journalistic visit to the home of Minnesota Twins infielder Rich Rollins and family. Diane Mills introduces the new singing discovery, Jonas and the Wailers. Meet Dave Rawberry. His emblem is displayed or on sale at newsstands.
Dan Turner scanning the world news-wise and a report.
KDWB News is where it's happening. This report just into the KDWB newsroom.
The FBI has announced the arrest of a Southern Illinois fugitive who was on its 10 most wanted list. Authorities say Charles Blank Charlie Harris, a former member of the notorious Shelton Gang in Southern Illinois years ago, was arrested in an abandoned home in the Pond Creek Bottom area near Fairfield, Illinois. Harris is a suspect in the slayings of a former girlfriend and a man who testified against him in a murder trial. Dave Rose reporting for KDWB News.
18 past 11 on KDWB. Girls, enter the Do You Look Like John Wayne contest. That's Afternoons with Jim O'Neill.
Remember. KDWB Flashback.
Put in for those prizes. 1964, June. The Underbeat, Sweet Words of Love. Giants in our KDWB country, the Underbeats. Great sound, 1964, vintage, Sweet Words of Love. Another group from our KDWB country, the Corvettes, and a moment.
On KDWB. Friday night, Randy Cook appears with the Aardvarks at the Parkway Ballroom in Foley.
Join Don DuChene with the Mystics this Friday night at the Diamond Point Ballroom in Sauk Centre. Wednesday night, June 23rd, see Peter, Paul, and Mary, plus the jazz sounds of the Dave Brubeck Trio at Met Stadium.
Randy Cook appears with the Night Sounds, plus Richie and the Jades at the Lake Marion Ballroom in Hutchinson on June 23rd.
See the Inmates and Jonas and the Whalers at the Shoreview Roller Rink this Saturday night.
Jim O'Neill joins the Jades and the Inmates at the Medina Ballroom on July 4th. This Friday night, join Randy Cook at the Playland Ballroom in Kimball, Minnesota, with the Cordon Blues and the Gents in a battle of the bands.
Look for the swinging gentlemen of KDWB in your area soon.
When it's happening, KDWB's there.
Astronauts White and McDivitt have arrived in the nation's capital for decorations. Astronaut Ed White had this to say when he arrived in Washington.
It's wonderful to be here in Washington. You know, I did a lot of growing up here. I went to high school at Western High School, and it's nice to come back, and it's a real honor to be back here under these circumstances.
Astronaut Ed White on the KDWB Thursday Morning Report.
Anyone can tune a radio in, but only KDWB can turn you on.
Once again, that beautiful weathercast. Mostly fair to partly cloudy. Just a few little strips of clouds in the sky there. A little temperature change. 75 to three-quarter mark for a high today and tomorrow. Low tonight, tomorrow night, 55. Clear at present time, 68. Trunk degrees.
The KDWB trunks are coming.
Did you say tanks?
No, I said trunks.
Well, aren't there any tanks?
Just trunks. No tanks.
You're welcome. KDWB.
Stones, exclusive instant discovery a while back. I can't get no satisfaction.
From Dayton, Ohio to KDWB.
A federal judge here in Dayton says the case of Gilbert Hagerman may lead to a federal law making shooting at military aircraft a serious offense.
On KDWB, for women only, Jim O'Neill's John Wayne lookalike contest.
You're hearing it happen on the Where It's Happening station, KDWB.
Police are conducting a reinvestigation this morning into the murder of a Racine, Wisconsin divorcee found bludgeoned to death in a ditch several weeks ago. For that report, we go now to Racine, Wisconsin.
The blood, which impregnated a chunk of sand taken from Racine's North Beach earlier this month, was found to be the same type as that of Mrs. Patricia Ann Oley, whose brutally beaten body was found in a shallow ditch last May 27th. Scene Detective Captain Thomas Ketting said the State Crime Laboratory in Madison reported the finding after completing special tests for determination of the blood type found in the sand. The crime lab cooperated June 2nd that the sand sample sent by Racine police contained blood, but that the type was difficult to determine because of partial decomposition caused by contact with soil bacteria. The area where the sand impregnated blood was found was at North Beach and was about 5 days earlier. Mrs. Oley's head had been battered with a blunt instrument, which authorities said was probably the grooved sand of an automobile bumper jack. The imprint of such a device was found on one of the murdered woman's arms, according to authorities.
At 14 minutes before 12, as the news goes, so go the mornings on KDWB.
Friday is fun night at the Prom Center. Friday night, enjoy the Whiskey a Go-Go Show. Then you'll kick your heels to old-time music furnished by the Jolly Brothers. It's all presented by Coca-Cola and the Prom Center. This Friday night, you can register for a free Honda to be given away July 9th. Just register. It's just that easy. Remember, Friday is fun night on the Prom Center on the Midway from 9 till 12:30.
The word is getting around. This is America's vacation belt. Great weather here, and it's continuing that way, at least for the next 24 hours. Clear again tonight. Continued mild, variable winds, mostly easterly, less than 10 miles an hour, southerly tomorrow. High today and tomorrow, 75. Low tonight, tomorrow night, 55. 6-8, current degree number. Southeast 5 for winds, 47 humidity. Clear, 13 noddle, 12 noon.
You'll hear it all on KDWB.
KDWB Flashback.
1964.
The hit is... So we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel and we're gonna get married. We really love you and we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel.
-66 degrees.
The big news comes first on KDWB.
Don DuChene reporting. St. Paul, 24-year-old Dennis Linehan is to appear in Ramsey County District Court at 9:30 a.m. Monday to stand trial on three charges in connection with the death of 14-year-old babysitter Barbara Iverson. Yesterday, a county grand jury indicted Linehan on charges of first-degree murder, third-degree murder, and kidnapping after a nine-hour session. County Attorney William B. Randall called nine witnesses, including the dead girl's parents, Mr. and Mrs. George Iverson, and Mr. and Mrs. Glenn Hansen, with whose children Barbara was sitting when abducted and slain. She was killed the night of June 9th, and her body was found the night of July 26th. Linehan, who was already in custody on other charges, became later. Moose Lake, Minnesota. Two men who escaped from the Moose Lake minimum custody camp in a stolen car after two men were killed yesterday were captured by Carleton County Sheriff's deputies shortly thereafter. 20-year-old Henry Mason and 23-year-old John Pittman, both of St. Paul, surrendered peacefully at nearby Sturgeon Lake after their car had gone in a ditch. They made no statements in connection with the deaths of 22-year-old Stanley Means of Pipestone and 24-year-old Gerald Johnson of Detroit Lakes, who were killed shortly after noon yesterday. Assistant camp supervisor Eugene Hansen said the four men and a fifth, whom was wounded, knew each other well enough to speak and that no motive for an attack had been pinpointed. The men were to have been taken to the St. Cloud State Reformatory for custody last night, and then they are scheduled to be returned to Carleton County for any subsequent hearings. KDWB traffic line, the Minnesota traffic death count stands at 418 this morning compared with 482 one year ago. The most recent victims are a 64-year-old St. Paul man and his 18-year-old son. Alec Elmer Robido and his son Lloyd of Alameda Street were killed, and three persons injured in a two-car collision a mile north of Randall, Minnesota, yesterday afternoon. St. Paul, a Ramsey County court order voiding Governor Carl F. Rovog's veto of the legislature's reapportionment bill will be appealed to the state Supreme Court. The governor said yesterday that he was disappointed but not surprised. Rovog declined to say whether or not he will run for another term. He said he will announce his plans at what he called the proper time. Austin, Texas, a 22-year-old University of Texas junior described as suave and articulate is in a county jail at Austin, Texas this morning charged with double murder. James Cross is accused of slaying two 21-year-old co-eds from Dallas whose bodies were found near Austin last week. Officials say Cross telephoned police to say he wanted to confess the slayings of Shirley Stark and Susan Rigsby, who disappeared in Austin July 18th. Police say they cannot give any details of Cross's statement under the new Texas Penal Code, which limits the amount of information that can be released in such cases, but they say they do have a motive. Washington Justice Department lawyers are scheduled to file suit in federal court at Jackson, Mississippi today, challenging the constitutionality of the state's poll tax. Mendon, Louisiana, Director James Farmer of the Congress of Racial Equality plans to lead a civil rights march on the town hall at Mendon, Louisiana today. In Bogalusa, at the opposite end of the state, Negro leaders plan another double march on City Hall, the third in 4 days. West Point, Mississippi, 18-year-old Mike Royce, the son of Wisconsin's Democratic Congressman Henry Royce, is in jail at West Point on manslaughter charges. Royce is charged in the death of Patrolman B. Cowart, who collapsed and died while searching the youth in a civil rights demonstration yesterday. Saigon, four once powerful South Vietnamese generals, including former Premier Khan, have been fired from their jobs. Khan lost his job as roving ambassador and was ordered home for questioning about financial corruption. Tokyo, a North Vietnamese broadcast monitored in Tokyo, tells of the first public appeal by South Vietnamese communist guerrillas for direct aid in the war from North Vietnam. The statement called on North Vietnam to actively assist the Viet Cong in their efforts to win South Vietnam for communism. West Los Angeles police in L.A. say veteran character actor Everett Sloan apparently committed suicide because he feared he was going blind. The 55-year-old Sloan was found dead in his bedroom by his wife yesterday. Death was attributed to an overdose of barbiturates. From the KDWB Weather Bureau direct line, considerable cloudiness, occasional showers today, decreasing cloudiness tonight, becoming partly cloudy Sunday. High today, 75. Low Saturday night, 55. Sunday, a high of 78. Humidity now, 87. Cloudy, a northwest wind, 3. Twin City temperature, 66 degrees. Reporting for KDWB News, Don DuChene.
That's the big news on the big news station, KDWB St. Paul, a servant to the great North Country.
Giant, 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 giant.
This is it. Number one.
There's the man, that's Frank, who is now vacationing in a ship yet. I noticed the size of this in the news yesterday. Let's see, 168 feet long. This is a yacht. He chartered it. And other movie stars aboard there and a young movie starlet. And they're living it up off the coast of New England. Frank Sinatra, that's a 1964 classic sound. Softly as I leave you. 507 KDWB secret number contest time. Remember that bit. Charlie Brown will have that going, coming up with a morning report. And your secret number, we could be given it, and it's worth a lot of cash. 66 degrees, 87 humidity. Let me check it out here.
What's the Twin Cities weather gonna?
KDWB. Got the brand new vital information here and all the stats and everything. Checked all the meters. A low pressure area this morning is centered over southern Minnesota, moving slowly eastward. Showers and thunderstorms associated with this low occurred over much of the north-central states during the past 24 hours, with amounts ranging up to 2.5 inches, which fell at Bismarck, North Dakota. So they got a lot of rain there. You shouldn't argue about it. Should be good for the crops. Cooler air moving southward into the Dakotas and portions of Minnesota yesterday as the Canadian high-pressure area moved southward west of the low. Now, highs yesterday ranged from the lowest of 61 at Lemon, South Dakota, to 89. At Pixtown, South Dakota, Minnesota highs ranged from the low 70s in northern sections to the mid-80s in the extreme south. Showers and thunderstorms are expected to continue today over the eastern sections of the five-state area, with clearing skies moving eastward from the Dakotas tonight and Sunday. This morning, temperatures over the area range from the 50s in North Dakota in the extreme western South Dakota region and northern Minnesota to a few low 70s in southern Iowa. For the Twin Cities, the brand new word here, considerable cloudiness with occasional light rain today. Decreasing cloudiness tonight, becoming fair to partly cloudy Sunday. A little cooler today and tonight, a little warmer Sunday. Northerly winds 10 to 18 today, decreasing tonight. High today 75, low tonight 55, Sunday a high of 78, and the low Sunday night 58. Vital stats, we have 87 humidity, a southwest wind 3, barometer 2971, cloudy 66, KDWB degree. Johnny Rivers.